Hi friends, I'm Dr. N.D. Lokhande and it's my pleasure to contact you through this online lecture. For the students of BA Part 3, we will discuss paper number 9, English Drama. You have studied some forms of literature in first year and second year. This year, you have to study 5 papers of special English. And one of those papers is English Drama. This is paper number 9 for the fifth semester 5, and for the semester 6, this will be paper number 14. So before beginning, we shall see what is the syllabus. This year, Shivaji University has revised the syllabus of BA Part 3, and this is the revised syllabus for semester 5. For this paper, you will study 2 general topics and 2 plays that are prescribed by the university. There are 8 modules in all for both semesters. As far as semester 5 is concerned, there are 4 modules. In the first module, module means unit. That is another word for unit. They call it module. In the first module, we shall see the definition of drama and different elements or aspects of drama. The second unit is about tragedy. Under this unit, we will discuss the definition of tragedy, nature of tragedy, rise and development of tragedy through different centuries. And then, there will be 2 plays for our study. One of them is The Importance of Being Earnest. This is a comedy by Oscar Wilde, who is a very famous 19th century English dramatist. We will study this play. I would like to appeal you to go through the PDF copy if you will find of the play. You have the time. Due to the lockdown and due to the widespread coronavirus, it is not possible to attend the colleges and classrooms. But you can use this time positively. You can find the details about this play on Google. You can read about Oscar Wilde, and his other plays are also equally funny and hilarious. You can also read this play online or offline, and that would enrich your experience of reading, and that will help you to understand the play better when the colleges will reopen. So this is my appeal to you. Please use this time to go through the prescribed plays. You will easily find this play. This is a very popular play, and also the author is extremely popular all over the world, and you will find, you will enjoy the reading, I am confident. The fourth module, under this module, we have to study world famous tragedy by William Shakespeare. Shakespeare has been translated in all languages of the world, and his 4 tragedies are very, very famous. Macbeth, Othello, Hamlet, and King Lear. These are the 4 great tragedies by William Shakespeare, and he is known for his writing skills because of these 4 excellent plays. And Hamlet is probably one of the most popular plays on world theater. You are lucky that you will study Hamlet as a student. And again, I will appeal you, all literature, all writing of Shakespeare is available on the net. Hamlet is also available. Some videos about the plays are also available. So I again request you, during the lockdown period, please watch the play Hamlet. I would also suggest to you to watch the Hamlet. It has been translated into Marathi also. It is available in print form. It is also available in video forms. So you can read the Marathi translation of this play also. Before we start actual study of the play, you can read it in Marathi edition also. So Hamlet is a tragedy by William Shakespeare. Hamlet is a tragic hero, and when we will meet actually, we will discuss in detail what are the features of this great tragedy by Shakespeare. Now coming to the 6th syllabus of 6th semester, again there are 4 modules. There again are 2 general topics and to actual place have been prescribed by the university. As I told you, the syllabus is revised this year, and these are the new places for the students of literature. I'm sure you have studied the play The Great Departure by Satish Alekar, and here both the plays that are prescribed for your study are Indian plays. They are written by Indian authors, their themes and their story is essentially Indian. In the fifth module, we shall see different types of drama. As drama is a genre of literature, there are also different types of drama. It is tragedy is there, some are comedies, satires are there, farces are there, black comedy, dark comedy, different types of drama. We will discuss different types of drama under this unit. And then, under the sixth module, we will study what is comedy. Comedy, you know that comedy is one of the forms of drama, types of drama, and again we shall see what are the different definitions of comedy, what are the features of comedy, and how did comedy develop throughout the centuries. We shall study the journey of comedy in English literature, in Indian literature also. Now, we will study two plays in sixth semester. One of them is Nagamandala by Girish Karnad. You know that Girish Karnad is Jnanpith Award winner Indian author who recently passed away. Some plays are very historic as far as Indian theatre is concerned, and one of them is Nagamandala. This play is also originally, it was written in Kannada language, it has been translated into English, and it is one of the very famous Indian plays. And now the last play which has been prescribed for our study is Harvest by Manjula Padmanabhan. This is again a play that will discuss the Indian themes, the Indian action, and we will study these two plays in the sixth semester. But meanwhile, I would like to appeal you, please go through the plays, all four plays. Dear friends, for this whole academic year, you have to study four plays. I would request you to study these two plays in the beginning, as you can begin your reading with these two plays. These are available on the Google. And these, as far as these two plays, I am not sure whether they are available on the net, but you can get the summary, you can get the story, you can get yourself familiar with the story of these two plays. So, this is the framework of syllabus. I wanted you to introduce to the framework of the syllabus. And I am sure you cannot say that the syllabus is very vast. See, drama is a very interesting form of literature. It is actually not written to be read, but it is designed for performance. We shall see what is drama in the next few slides. But meanwhile, it is my earnest appeal to you. Please start your reading. Don't waste your time. You have a lot of time. You are at home, and all of you have smartphones. So introduce yourself to the actual reading. I am afraid what will happen after the colleges will reopen, you will not get the ample time for the actual reading, textual reading. So this is the time which is available to you, and you can use this time for actual reading. So if you will read the actual plays, then we will discuss the general topics. And I am sure if you will study the plays before, in the first stage, then you can understand the general topics in a better manner. Because before studying the play, it is quite hard to study the general topics. But the study and critical study of the play will help you to understand the theoretical points in a better manner. So this is the syllabus. I am sure you have got the syllabus. The syllabus is also available on the website of Shivaji University. You can get the syllabus from anywhere. The point is that syllabus is quite short, and we have to study only two plays for this fifth semester. And I am sure you will It's not going on. It's wrong. And I'm sure this is the third slide, I think. I'm sure you will get yourself familiar with the syllabus. Now let us come to the first module. What is the first module? Definition and elements of drama. This is the first module that we are going to study. So before going any further, let us see what actually the drama is. Drama, it was actually a Greek word which meant to act or to dram or to perform. The word drama has been originated from the Greek word dram. That means to perform. So drama itself means to perform. So any piece of literature that is meant for performance is called drama. Drama is one of the most ancient forms of literature. It is very old as the human civilization itself. So when men were living, human beings were living in the forest, they were living in the caves, drama was there. Because for drama, we do not require writing. Drama was in the oral form in the beginning, and drama is the oldest form of literature. It is just an imitation of life. It presents the slice of human life. So imitation of actual human life is as old as the human civilization. So drama is one of the oldest and most ancient forms of literature. There is a basic difference between drama and other forms of literature. Like short story, novel or a poem, they are written, they are composed to be read by someone. But drama is basically designed for performance. It is a teamwork. You cannot read the drama in a room. You can read a poem all alone. You can read a novel at your home. But it is not expected that you should read the drama at home. It is expected that you should go to the theater. You should watch the drama. So drama is not for reading. Drama is for watching. So it is composed for performance. Drama is a team activity. It requires contribution of different aspects of the theater. What is actually drama? Drama is the imitation of life. Human life is a complex life. Different stories are there in human society. And drama or the dramatist presents just a piece of that human life. It requires audience and it is essentially a group activity.